Good afternoon, friends. I'm Gaurav, and I'm coming from a place called Sivani, which is a tribal district in South Madhya Pradesh. And I'm representing Agrini. So the story starts 3.5 years back when I was establishing mobile networks, because I am an engineer accidentally. And suddenly realized that this is not what I want to do. Got back home, quitting my job, my parents abusing me for that. And not knowing what I want to do actually, but trying to do something in education, because I had a very bad habit of getting into arguments with people, social arguments, political arguments, and a single conclusion that I got out of it is that all of them end with education as a solution. You start talking about girls' education, dowry, and it's end. People in the end said, one day everyone will be aware, people will be educated, and it will be resolved. So education was something I wanted to do. And I was an engineer. So I had an old computer in my home. And I just picked it up and put it in an Anganwadi. So these Anganwadis are, I know few people know about them. Let me explain. Anganwadis are small community centers in every village. Now they have started doing Anganwadis in cities also. They are in every ward almost, with a staff of 2 people, both of them female. And they are responsible for taking care of malnutrition and preschooling education, pre-maternity care in that area. So as my focus was in education, so I just took that computer and I placed it in that Anganwadi. First day when I reached there, I asked few friends of mine. They agreed to volunteer with us, and they were carrying these sheets for a baseline assessment that how much children know right now, because we were planning to do something there to understand what change we were able to make. During the process, I observed a child, and when I was carrying a camera, so when I was clicking, other children were coming to me. They were excited about the camera, they were trying to touch it. This kid was hiding, and I somehow managed to click him. When I inquired about the kid, because he was not talking to me, and I'm a bit comfortable with children, so I usually make them happy with me. But he was not talking to me at all. When I inquired about the kid, Anganwadi worker told me that her words were, "Bhaiya, ye kuch nahi bolega. This kid will not speak anything." And during in coming 4 or 5 days, I inquired more, and I came to know that his father committed suicide for some reason, and his mother works as a maid in some hostel around. So she's out for the whole day, and he just don't mingle with other children and keeps on going around the village all day. Then we started what we wanted to do. We put in computer. I bought some Hindi-English rhymes, musical rhymes, CDs, some presentations I created to teach alphabets, numbers. We painted it beautifully, and we celebrated birthdays. So during all this going on for 45 days, 20th day, 22nd day, I observed that this kid, actually started moving his lips. Especially when musical rhymes were going on. And I clicked something on 45th day. This was Sanjay. And this was the day when Sanjay for the first time came in front of the class and recited a poetry. So this whole incident and that experience of 3-4 months actually indicated towards a very big problem, which is substandard government preschooling in India. And these were the five reasons we identified for that. There was no enough infrastructure, no defined curriculum, no regular assessments, even no assessments at all, no proper training for teachers, and no teaching aids provided to them. There are 1.4 million Anganwadi Balwadi centers in this country, serving 5 crore children. This is actually the pre-schooling government system. Interestingly, right to education gives right to education to a child age 6, but not to a child age 3 or 4. So this is a very big gap. A child going to a private school gets 15 class teachers, goes through 15 annual exams, and one going to government system gets 12 class teachers, 12 annual exams, you are giving both the same certificate. So the problem is big, even very big. So what we do? We don't start nursery schools. We transform these Anganwadis into efficient nursery schools. And we do it using advanced learning techniques. One of them was this multimedia, and there are more. After that, we spent 2 years understanding preschooling education. I traveled across. I visited a lot of organizations, a lot of preschools, nursery schools. And we developed a whole model using, we tried to make it low cost so that we can replicate it in as much as possible centers. So what is that model? Education anywhere in schools, universities, preschools is based on 3 things. First is infrastructure, second is processes, and third is people. So we start with improving infrastructure. What we do, we make these spaces child-friendly. As you can see, we paint the lower part of the walls that is approachable. We make it a workbook because it is not possible to print as many as workbooks and provide it to these children. We establish a toy library, which is a must when you work with such young kids. Second is putting in processes. There's no curriculum. There's no defined curriculum in government Anganwadis. No assessment processes. So we came up with a program, a curriculum, collected study material for that from different places. We developed some of ourselves. There are other organizations working in the space. We took some of this from them. We put in these processes, and finally we train Anganwadi workers to adopt these processes and work through all this infrastructure themselves and take it forward. So who's being benefited? It's children aged 3 to 5 attending Anganwadis for preschooling education, Anganwadi workers, and finally the community. Impact. So till date, we have worked with 4 Anganwadi centers. We have trained 4 Anganwadi workers, 20 plus children raised directly. Outcome we observed on the basis of test feedbacks and weekly growth charts. There was increase in learning level of children as most of them are now comfortable with alphabets. They can recite more poems. They're more confident. Increased attendance, increased participation in class, and improvement in motor skills. Impact. So our children admitted to first standard are performing better than others. As I told, we started our first Anganwadi 2 years before, so now those children are in class second. Anganwadi worker became more efficient as a preschool teacher because she now is more interested in doing that work, apart from other work she do. And community got more aware because the feedback we started getting from parents during the community meetings told us that. So this is the growth plan. Right now, we are, as I told, we have worked in 4 schools. In coming year, which is going on 13-14, we want to establish a cluster of such efficient rural preschools in MP. These will be 30 Anganwadi centers. And we'll start some advocacy process. As we discussed initially, that it is a big problem. We cannot reach everywhere. So this is the tool we think will work for us. On the next year, we'll be working in two other states with five centers in each state. Reason is that we want to test this same model in regional languages. And by that year, we'll be increasing our focus more into advocacy and knowledge sharing. Knowledge sharing is like, as I told, there are other organizations working in this space. They're also doing good job. Few of them doing better than us also. But they're not connected together. So if we can, and also you cannot find a lot of study material or processes, curriculum online if you'll try to search. So we want to create an online space where all these things are available. We want to collect these organizations. And third, the most important thing is advocating this to the government. In 2015-16, we'll continue with the same strategy of trying it in two more states. We have planned it to be Odisha and Tamil Nadu. We are trying to do it in very different type of cultures so that we can understand that this model is working across cultures also or not. This is the slide which interests everyone, which is growth plan and money. So this is the same plan. Number of states, 1, 1, 2, and 2. Number of Anganwadis, 4, then 30, 10, 10. This is our upgrade cost per school, which is 80,000 rupees per school. Right now, when we work in MP ourselves, and it becomes 1.5 lakh, which is 70,000 more when we'll be doing it in other states, because we'll have to develop study material in local languages there. We'll have to partner with some organization to get it implemented. So this is the total upgrade cost, advocacy and knowledge sharing cost. And as I said, that we'll try to increase our focus on advocacy, knowledge sharing more as we move ahead. So partnerships to implement this thing, we have partnered with Vodafone Foundation, Central Asia Group of Institutes, Goonj. Goonj right now is helping us with toys as they work in the space of collecting old toys and segregating good one out of them and delivering it. Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India, and for funding, we were with Vodafone Foundation's World of Difference program this year. Thanks to Dasra for that. And Caring Friends is an organization based in Mumbai who are supporting us. Recognitions, we won social innovation competition at Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. Prerna Fellowship Award by Indian Institute of Management, Lucknow, and Network 18. Spark the Rise round winner, we were when I came here, and now we are finalists also. And the Dasra Social Impact Program, we were also given a Republic Day recognition by MP government. This is the team. I'm Gaurav. I used to look like this before. Okay, leave it. So he's Manoj, who is doing a PhD on this model right now. Is Mahindra, he stays in the field. He is just genius in field work. And he's Navindu. We are like four people, nice people. And what we need? So we need funds. We need 83.3 lakh rupees in coming 3 years. We need computers, laptops, tablets. So if there are people from banks, corporate software, so they can help us for that. We need digital cameras, volunteers. Mary, keep it in mind. Study material and toys. So our vision is to eliminate the disparity in quality of education among all children. And we're going to do it using innovative learning techniques to bridge gap between private schooling and substandard government schooling. Thank you.